हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम आई डूइंग दिस वीडियो। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो वी गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू टेक एक्सटर्नल वॉइस इनपुट सिग्नल फॉर अ मैटलैब, मीन्स हाउ टू रिकॉर्ड अ सिग्नल इन अ मैटलैब, how to play that signal, how to plot that signal, and how to take the spectrum of that signal. That is nothing but the graph, the time versus frequency. So this type of concept is very much important for speech processing topic. So whenever we study a speech processing, in that case we must know how to record, how to play, how to take a spectrum, because without a spectrum you can't process a signal. So that's why for a speech processing you must know how to take a spectrogram of that audio signal. So let us start. So first open the MATLAB software. So this is my MATLAB. So already we discussed so many things about the command windows and editor windows, how they works. So today I will directly start the actual topic. So this is the editor window. So in this editor window I will give the heading, that is a percentage. So I will write the title, how to record the audio signal in MATLAB, also how to play that audio. Okay, next thing, how to plot that signal. Last one, how to take spectrogram of that signal. Okay, so these are the today's topic. So let us start. So before going to start, that we know that in a MATLAB we have a different inbuilt command. So basically through that command you can study or you can understand how to do the recording or how to do the processing. So there is one command is there for recording purpose. So first go to the command window, just search help, write audio recorder. Okay, so just go to the audio recorder page. So see here, this is a help that already present in MATLAB software. So in that you can see the how to record a signal. So let us check. So this is a basic command, that is a recorder is equal to audio recorder. So this is the first basic command is there. Second one is a record is equal to audio recorder, that is sampling frequency, then whatever the bits are there and channels. So basically you can set whatever the samples, then you can define sample size, and the last one, you know, is nothing but number of channels. So here you can see already in MATLAB they have given some basic input arguments, like a sampling rate obviously is in hertz. So you can take a different sampling rates, 8000, 11000, 22000, 50, 44000, 100, 48000, 96000, like this. So basically default we can take. So it depends upon the whatever the application you are going to do. So as per that you have to take a sampling rate. Again it depends upon your application. So second one is nothing but bit per sample. So how many bits you can take. Again that values depends on the audio hardware installed. Whatever the audio hardware is there, means applications. So as per that, this bit will be changed, 8, 16 and 24. Again, yes, maximum time we take the default bit, that is 8. The third one is nothing but n channels. So basically there are two conditions. Obviously one is a mono and dual, means stereo. So you can take both. If you want to take one, then you can take the one. So like this, this is nothing but audio recorder command and their syntax. Okay, so let us start the actual programming. Now again you can, if you see at the bottom of the audio recorder syntax, there is one example is already there. So let us do one thing, just copy that example so you can understand very easily. And now after that you can apply whatever the input signal as per your applications. So this is nothing but one example they have given, create an audio recorder object. So here let us take as it is for your understanding. For example, they have taken an audio recorder as a recording purpose. They have given a name, recorder object, that is RECOBJ. You can take anything. They have given a RECOBJ. Here they have taken a 44100 is nothing but what? Is nothing but that already we discussed that 44100 is nothing but the sampling rate. Second one, 16 is nothing but the bits per sample. And the third one is nothing but 2, means they have taken for a stereo, means dual purpose. But here I will take the default values like sampling rate 8000, then sample rate is nothing but 2 for a mono purpose, that is only single purpose. So these are the changes. Now if you see the second line, what they are given, so gate. What is the meaning of gate? So basically in first sentence we have taken that audio signal, means that is nothing but recording, but still we have not recorded the signal, but we defined some parameters. So whatever the recorder signal is there, they have to maintain these conditions. So absolutely whenever we take that signal with this parameter, so that parameters automatically apply to that signals, that is 8000 samples should be there, 8 sample rate should be there, and the one that is a mono. So whatever the conditions are there, so through that get command it will take that parameters. Next one, now if you go to the next, so here they have written collect a sample of your speech with a microphone and plot the signal data. So simply again I will copy this whole code. Okay, so basically for example they have taken for 5 seconds, you can take 10, you can take 15, but as per your signals you have to change some sampling rate. So here I have taken only 10 seconds. So here what we have taken, that is a again I have taken that output objective is equal to audio recorder. So this is basically nothing but the actual command that will take a signal through the microphone. Means you can connect as a headphone as your for your input signal. Through that headphone you can give the any speech signal as an input to the this audio recorder. So this display, it will display only the start speaking, means in command window it will show the start speaking word. After that you can start to speak the whatever you want for 10 second only. After 10 second means that is a record blocking, means after 10 second through this command it will stop the recording. Okay, means whatever the signal is there, that signal will be automatically stopped. Then it will display the end of recording, means whatever you are recording that will be end, and that message will be shown on the command window. Okay, this very simple code is there. Now third one and the most important is how to play that signal. Again it's very simple. So there is one direct command is available in MATLAB, that is a play. Just you have to write whatever the output argument is there, RECOBJ. So it will automatically play whatever the recorded signal. Then the last one is you can't directly plot the signal. You have to take that data and after that you can plot the signal. So for that you have to store data in a double precision array, because whatever the speech signal is there, in speech signal the sometimes the voice signal is there and there is an unvoiced signal is there. So it can't be directly plot that signal. So first we have to take that data, audio data, in the form of gate audio data, that is a double precision array. So after that you can plot the signal. Simply you have to write plot whatever the my recording, that is output argument for gate audio data. Now up to this, first thing we have taken one command, that is audio recorder. We have defined some sampling rate 8000. Okay, sample rate is 8, and whatever the is a mono channel, so I have taken 1. If there is a stereo, means double, so in that case you have to take a 2. So then I have taken that data into the gate. Then I have taken one command. So through this command you can record a signal for 10 seconds, because I have written a 10 here. So it will record means signal for 10 seconds. Then it will display the end of recording. Then it will play. And the most important is whenever you want to plot that signal, you have to take that data into double precision array. So that's why here I have taken gate audio data. Now the most important thing, if you want to plot a spectrum of your audio signal, in that case how to plot that. So again there is a command is available in MATLAB. So there is one command, that is nothing but spectrogram. So that is a my recording, means whatever the plot is there you can directly take as a my recording. Now if you want to see the syntax, just go to the spectrogram help. So you will get whatever the information about the that spectrogram command. So in that x is nothing but obviously whatever the input for that, that is my recording is input. Then I have taken a different windows. Basically, these are nothing but windows 128, 120, 128. So again is a overlapping concept is there, and that is y axis. Means whatever the frequency is there, that going to plot on a y axis. Okay, with respect to time. So you can take any spectrogram syntax as per the your choice, as per your applications, what parameters you need, as per that you can take. So, okay, so for my programming I have taken this different window with 128, 120, 128. You can change that windows and you can see the whatever the changes happens in the spectrogram. My main motive is how to record the audio signal in MATLAB, how to play, how to plot, and how to take a spectrogram. So I hope you understand how to record a signal, how to play, okay, and how to take a spectrogram. Okay, so just go to the run option. So first I will save this file, okay, somewhere, for example. So just I will give the name, for example pl.m. okay, so it is showing a start speaking. Okay, so you can speak anything for 10 seconds. Whenever the 10 second complete, it will show the end of record. Okay, now you got that. Basically, whatever you listen, you hear now, that is nothing but 10 second voice. But there is one change has to be done, because there is only one window it showing, that is spectrogram, frequency and time. So I want to plot both signals, means recorded as well as spectrum of that. So I have to take one command, sorry, figure. So once again I will run the program. So see here, again the in command window is showing the start speaking. So already I am speaking, so whatever I am going to speak, that already recording. Now here end of recording. Okay, so whatever you hear now, that is nothing but recorded signal. So now you can check, this is a figure 1. So basically this is nothing but whatever the recorded signal. Now if you see the signal, okay, okay, so this is nothing but voice signal. So you are getting whenever there is a voice signal is there. So in voice there are two concepts are there. Sometimes there is unvoice and voice, means whenever we talk, between your voice, human voice, the some silence should be there, obviously, because human can't talk continuously. Basically there are different external parameters are there, means external voice is there, external ear is there, like noise, that all parameters obviously are present in that signal. So that's why if you see the signal, in that signal whenever there is a human voice is present, in that human voice it's showing the maximum amplitude, means maximum peaks. So that is nothing but that whatever the human voice is there, that present at this particular points. And some cases if you see, there is a small peaks are there, small amplitudes are there of that signal, that is nothing but that signal is a unvoiced signal, or the different noises are present there. So again So most important application in speech processing, or you can say as a one of the most important project, that you can separate whatever the unvoiced signal and the voice signal by using a different algorithms, so that we can study maybe in another video. Okay, so I hope you will like this video. And the second graph is nothing but the CPEC. This is nothing but spectrogram. So whatever we recorded, that we have taken into the spectrogram form. Okay, means in a frequency domain form. Basically, the frequency in hertz and is the time. So whenever we process the signal, means we need a speech processing. In that case, we have to find out whatever the spectrogram of the signal. Now you can make whatever the operations on this spectrogram, because we know that whenever we do the speech processing, we have to that signal should be in a frequency domain, because as compared to time domain, it's easy to process or easy to apply any mathematical conditions to frequency domain signal is easy as compared to the time domain signal. Okay, so I hope you will like this video. If you like, then please subscribe my channel, share and like my channel.